Hello, 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 everyone. How are you? Hello. Hello, everyone. Hello, hello, hello. So I was getting ready to come in and I said, what better way to come in than with the stars themselves? Hello, everyone. Hello. So, so excited. Hey, divorce girls. Hola, ¿cómo estás? Hey, KBBMO. Hello, Randy there, Gilson. I want to send this out to see if I can send it, but I can't. So maybe I want to make sure that my folks also see me. Oh, so good to see you all. Hola, hola, bienvenidos todos to Be Latina News and to this month's New Moon in Cancer Q&A. I cannot wait to talk about this, to answer some questions. Hello, bienvenidos, bienvenidos. Hola, hello from New York City. Hey, K Smith Studio. Bienvenidos todos. Hello, hello, hello. So I want to get into it. This is going to be a really beautiful experience. When we step into the new moon in Cancer as a community, as a group, and ask questions and deepen into our own healing and our own expansion, there's such great opportunity for us to heal, to release, and to step even further into the dreams that we are seeding. So hola, hola, bienvenidos. Hello, Ashanti Universe. Yasmin C came in. Hello, hello, hello. So I actually want to give people a couple more minutes to show up because I know that more folks are coming in. And I want you to prepare yourself because we're going to open up to ask questions. And you can ask and say, well, this is my sign. How will this new moon affect me? You can also ask if something's been coming up for you specifically around this new moon. Hey, Ashanti Universe, so, so good. And so I think this is about as much as focus we're going to get for right now. So I'm going to begin. Hello, everyone. Welcome. My name is Vanessa Codorniu, and I am the contributor for Be Latina News, who writes astrology articles every month. Today, we just published the new moon in Cancer. Deep self-care is in the air. So if you haven't read it, go check it out on Be Latina News. Now, I was asked to come on and do a takeover, and I was like, what better way to do a takeover than to talk about the new moon in Cancer? So now we know that in June 24th, we had a full moon, right? If y'all could remember that, the full moon. The title of that article was Full Moon and Redefining Éxito, Redefining Success. In the last couple of months, we've been dealing with eclipses. We've been dealing with retrogrades, right? Mercury in retrograde, all of these different shifts and changes. All of this set up to invite us into greater changes and to into decision-making that perhaps we've been holding back, but it's really our time to make that decision. And so Mercury is direct, so let's give some snaps up for that. I wanna hear some, see some snaps. We got Mercury direct. Mercury rules communication. It rules technology. And what winds up happening a lot of times, let's not be superstitious, pero when Mercury's in retrograde, we have a lot of miscommunication. We have a lot of situations where we may not know what's going on. And then we understand that Mercury's in retrograde. The great thing is this, Mercury went direct. We are now dealing with the planet of communication going direct. June 24th, we dealt with the full moon coming in, and that full moon was like, hey, how do you want to work? How do you want to live? Is this truly what you call success? And so the full moon was showing us that maybe what we've been doing wasn't working out. Maybe this rat race we've been on, trying to succeed, trying to make it. And so I hope that around the end of June, you took a moment to really ask yourself, and if you haven't, this is a great opportunity. How do I really want to work? How do I want to show up in the world? Am I giving too much of my time? And that's where that full moon was activated and working. That full moon, June 24th, is bringing us into this time right now. Right now, tonight, at 9:36 Eastern Standard Time, we're getting a new moon. The new moon happens when the sun and the moon are one in front of the other. And so we cannot see the moon in the sky, but it very much speaks to new beginnings. It speaks to creating new intentions and to becoming aware of what doesn't work and making a really powerful decision to release it. And so we're in this time of newness. We're in this time of recreation. Hola, bienvenido, Angelica, Jess V, Michi Fig. Welcome, 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 Alvin, or Alv1. And so the new moon, so let me tell you a little bit about the new moon, because I don't want to tell you everything because I want you to see the article and read the article, but I want to tell you a little bit more and then I'm going to open up for questions. So the new moon rules, motherhood, protection. It is symbolized by the crab. If you think about the crab, the meat is real soft inside. It's all soft and mushy, but inside there's this hard shell. And sometimes Cancerians, our boss ladies, our boss guys, they're showing up real tough and strong, but inside they're softies, they're so sensitive. And wherever we have Cancer in our chart, it shows us, oh, thank you, Iris. I'm so glad that you loved it. It shows up in that we may be a little extra protective, or that we may be showing up a little too protective. So this new moon is asking us to take some time to self-care. Now, self-care a lot of times is getting our manis done, which I didn't do it yet, right? Getting our hair done and did and hecho, and getting that massage on, which I got on yesterday, and that is all needed, and that is all wonderful, and that is all powerful. And yet, this new moon, and thank you for the hearts. Thank you for the hearts. This new moon is really asking us to go deeper. And why are we gonna go deeper? Because let's face it, a facial's gonna help us, a manicure will make us feel good, a new hair color will make us feel good, a hair piece, a new dress, all of that, a new piece of jewelry. But at the end of the day, the lasting changes, the lasting shifts, comes from doing the deep work. It comes from taking a moment to asking ourselves, what do I really need? Not my kids, not my boss, not my partner, not my mother, not my family, not my best friend, not my community. What do I really need? Thank you for the hearts. Thank you so much. And that is a question that a lot of us do not ask. We do the mani, we do this, we do that, and then we're like, sigue, 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 especially for Latinos, especially for immigrants, especially for first generation. We are so at it. We've been taught to have this hardworking ethic, and trust me, because I have it, I know. I've been dealing with healing that and taking more time off. When we take the time to ask ourselves what we really need, we may wind up coming up with, hey, I need a therapist. Hey, I need to work out. Oh, wow, I need some shut-eye, I need to sleep. And then we go to the next point where we may ask ourselves, have I been trying to do it all myself? Because what happens with us, hola, cafecito break, hola, Cindy, hola, hola, everyone, welcome to Be Latina News. My name is Vanessa Codorniu. I'm doing the takeover in astrology with the new moon Q&A. When we start asking these deep questions, when we understand that our family and our work and our career and our purpose is important, but we know that if we take care of ourselves, everything shifts. That's real power. That's real success. Because when we know what we need, we can take that moment to give it to ourselves. Now, I know so many of us, thank you for the hearts. So I know people who say to me, you know, I told him or her that if they didn't want a real relationship, that they could like break it off. And I'm like, mamita, papito, why are you putting your power into somebody else's hands? You know, and sometimes people are like, oh, but I told him I don't want this. I don't told this and I told that and I told my boss and I told that. We're still putting our power in other people's hands. When we get clear with our needs, we shift everything. Because notice, you know that there's that person in the office that doesn't get asked to stay later. You know that that person is not being tried. Nobody's trying them right now because they made it clear in their boundaries. So I want to read what you've been saying, and I love it. It's so great to connect with you all here. This is resonating with me so much. Glow and greens. Glow and greens. Get on Be Latina News and read that article, because that article goes into other areas, and I'll talk about it for a moment. Cafecito break, yes, mama, yes. And we know it, we know that we put ourselves last. We know that we do this. Oh, putting power in others' hands, yes, resonate, message received, so good. Because Iris, I've done it, I've been in a relationship where I'm like, listen, do not waste my time. And then months later, I'm sitting there, pero, didn't I tell him? And it's like, well, I told him, but did I tell myself? And then telling myself, did I take that moment to really change things in my life? And so everybody, hear this before I go into Q&A. This new moon is an amazing opportunity for you to sit down and say to yourself, it is now safe for me to be top priority. It is now safe for me to say no. It is now safe for me that if I don't want to go out tonight, it's okay to stay home. Hello, April. It is so good for me to stay home because we keep placing ourselves last. We keep doing the things we don't want to do. And then we're wondering why we're tired. Then we're wondering why we don't feel well. Now, I get it. The occasional sacrifice where we go to a party or we do something where we're like, oh, estoy cansada. We can do that. But guess what? If we do it all the time, if it's your way of life, we're gonna wind up este verano, pero super cansados. Iris, been there too, yes, needed to hear that. I know, I mean, and let me tell you, my mama was like, you're being a little too tough on my current future husband, but I was like, Mom, I went through a lot in my life. If I don't put the foot down and ask for what I want, I'm not gonna get it. And thankfully, he was receptive and here we are. Cafecito break, truth smackdowns with love, me encanta. Absolutely, the Perez sisters in New York City were just talking about this earlier. Oh, so true, so true, so true. And so this new money, you know, if you all know some cancers, we all get this image of like this cancer, you know, we're all weeping in the corner, feeling our feelings, and we're all in nostalgia, which I did cry today. I went to the gym, you know, self-care. And then for a moment, I thought about my parents, I thought about my abuelas. And back in the day, abuelas worked out by cleaning the house and doing their work. They weren't going to a gym, right? At least mine weren't, maybe yours are. I got emotional. And so expect that this new moon is gonna get you emotional. You may cry for loves that are lost. You may cry when reality hits you in the face and you're like, damn, I've been trying and trying to make this relationship work. It's not working. Me tengo que ir, I gotta go. And then you can cry. With this new moon, allow yourself to feel your feelings. Feeling your feelings is key because so much everyday life, we're pushing through. Well, what happens? We get angry, we get short-tempered, or as my friend who's heavily into science says, your myelin is short, girl. And the myelin is something that is around the nerve endings, y que when there's too, it's too much, we get a little impatient. And so allow yourself to feel emotional, allow yourself to feel your feelings. Iris says, yes, be intentional, love it. Thank you for sharing your experience and knowledge. So, so important. And so I want to open now. Does anybody have any questions about this new moon in Cancer? Because you know I could keep talking. Hola, La Cultura. Hola, Robin McDougall. Hello, welcome. Welcome, so excited for you to be here. Yes, growing and healing. And guess what? If anybody tells me you, I find it interesting because there's people who like come up to me and they're like, oh, I'm, hola, African warlock, how are you? They're like, well, I'm going to evolve and ascend. If we're on earth, my people, mi gente, if we're on earth, it means that our soul needed to be in our body, and it's learning lessons, and it's meeting souls that we love and working together, right? And organizations that we love, like Bilatina News, I love being here. Entonces, oh, delicioso cakes, I'm so glad to hear it. I'm gonna repeat it, no worries, mi amor, it's good. I get to reset the space. This is about new moon in Cancer that is happening tonight at 9:36 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Now I wanna talk a little bit about what this opportunity brings. Self-care, healing with your parents, healing with that, you know, your first family, your family of origin. So many times we move out into the world and keep replicating because we just don't know any better, right? Like I'm the oldest sister. I'm the one who had to navigate the education system. I had to translate for my mom. My dad got it, but I had to translate for him too. I was the first one. Entonces, a lot of years in my life, I was taken over and I had to learn, no, sister, nothing. I don't have to do everything all the time, and that we can ask for help. Are there any recommendations for rituals for this new moon? Yes, Mrs. Gomez West, I love this. There are recommendations. In the article, we talk about taking a bath. One of the simplest things. So what I love about the article, the New Moon in Cancer article that's on Bilatina News, and you can find that right here in the right in the bio link. You could go on and find it. It's like a mini workshop in New Moon, if you go into the article. But I'm gonna give you some recommendations for rituals. Go into the article, read it, because it asks really deep questions about reparenting. It asks questions about our relationship to overgiving, you know, overloving, taking over, being codependent, allowing ourselves to make ourselves last all the time. So it's a really great workshop in that. But another great ritual would be clean your house, literally. Cleanse your house spiritually. So you could take a candle, just a white candle, light it. And as you're breathing, and you want to make sure you breathe, right? So let's say this is a candle. I have one here, actually. Let's say this is a candle, because it is. You hold it in your hand, you breathe, and you set the intention. It is now safe for me to be in my home. It is safe for me to release the past. It is safe for me to feel my feelings. It is safe for me to accept that my mother gave me what she could, because the moon rules a mother and Cancer rules a mother. And it is okay for me to now reparent myself and take care of myself. Something like that. And there's more suggestions in the article. And then you light the candle, and you could leave it at an altar, right? Any space where you do some meditation or spiritual work. Or the opposite, you take it and you begin to walk all around your house into every corner. And as you do it, you're breathing in this energy of safety. Thank you for the hearts. You're breathing in the energy of healing. You're breathing in the energy of protection. And you walk into each corner. You say, I am safe. I release the past. I release the past. I heal my relationship with my mother. I allow myself to say no. These kind of affirmations. And then when you get to the door, open it, and you're like, whew, I release. And so in one of them, you lit the candle, like stay on the whole time. And in the other one, you go to each corner affirming it is now safe, right? It is now safe for me to set new pathways. It is safe for me to say no. It is safe for me to change now. It's safe for me to choose what I want and not make myself last all the time. Whatever resonates with you, and then blow it out. And why are we blowing it out? Because we're literally going out with the old. The new moon is that point in time where you look up at the sky tonight and you're not gonna see literally a moon. It's darkness. But it's this fertile soil for us to plant new intentions. And so when we go, I release, we're letting go, we're setting the intention and letting our mind, body, and spirit know that we are ready, willing, and able to let go of these energetic patterns and ready to reclaim new ones. And so that's just one of them. It could be also as simple as get in your bed, feel really comfortable. I know I'm giving you really practical like rituals, right? Get into bed, get really comfortable, and just breathe in. And just imagine what your home, ideal home is. And if it is the home that you have, allow yourself to imagine adding more plants to it, feeling even more comfortable. It is the reimagining of home, the re-envisioning of what makes us feel safe, and it is the healing and reparenting of our mothers. It's also intuition. So you could do a ritual where you prepare a bath, and you could just prepare a bath and put a couple of drops of, let's say, clary sage oil, or if you have another oil, lavender could still work, other oils that you have. You know, remember that our ancestors used whatever they had handy, because a lot of us think, oh, I have to order this particular thing. Mira, ojo, as my mom used to say, our ancestors used what was available. So you could prepare a bath, run the bath water, light one candle, because remember that the new moon is the darkness, and in a couple of days we're going to start seeing a little sliver of a moon. And then get in your tub with a couple of drops of oil and allow yourself to look at the space of the bathroom, to take in the darkness of it, to take in that one candle, and spend some time breathing in what you want to release. I release this pattern in love relationships. I release jobs that take advantage of me. I release being a doormat, or I release being too bossy, whatever it may be. And then breathe in the tub. I now allow myself to shine. I now allow myself to choose what makes me happy. Because another part of this new moon in Cancer, you know, we all are born into a tribe. We're born into a family. And sometimes, not always, we go along with what the family says because we don't want to be booted out. Thank you for los corazones. Thank you. Mucho amor. We don't want to be booted out. So a really powerful question when you're in the tub or lighting the sage is, where have I betrayed myself? I know betrayal is a serious word here, but where have I not listened to my intuition? Where have I surrendered my autonomy? Where have I not allowed myself to choose me? Like I remember, you know, something that happened many years ago. I applied to go to school abroad, to go to France, to study Francais in Paris. And it was a year abroad. They couldn't do 5 months or 6 months or semester. My mom called me after I was accepted. She's like, please don't do it. The family's going through a shaky time. And I need you near, even if you're upstate, you could come back to New York City. And I said, no, I didn't go because I felt like I had to choose my family at that time. And so there are moments where we have to choose our family, but this new moon is also asking us, are we choosing our family too much? Are we sacrificing our own individuality? Are we sacrificing our own desires? Are we sacrificing ourselves because of our mama? Are we sacrificing ourselves because of the tribe, of the family? And you know, we are the chain breakers. We are the generation that gets to break these patterns. That's what we're talking about. So I hope that this all resonates with you. Let me know, and thank you for the hearts. Iris says, I've been feeling very fatigued and I didn't realize it was a new moon brewing, but a lot of recent past relationships or situation things have come to surface. So I definitely feel this new moon. Absolutely, Iris. Oh my God. So I'm getting married in 2 weeks, right? This wedding was rescheduled twice. And a couple of ex-boyfriends wrote me who are maybe a little upset that maybe I didn't marry them in the past. They were like, well, don't chicken out of this one. And I was like, no, papi, we're all good. I'm getting married. And so past relationships are going to come up, whether they're being cute or whether they're not being cute or whether they're haunting us. Think about this new moon, right? The new moon in Cancer is also nostalgia. It's also the past, el pasado, right? And so that's why it's about making peace with the past too. Making peace. And you know, there's such great duality in our spirit. We're embodied in our spirit, living this life. And yet we know that we can receive messages from the other side. Yet we know that we have intuition. But in truth, we're still waking up every day having to live this life. So how do we make peace with the physical, everyday, practical life? Right? Hay que ir a trabajar. We have to pay the bills. And what our spirit is doing. And so, Iris, it's a really great time for you to take a bath. I know you take care of so many people, and I know that you take care of yourself, right? But give yourself some, I don't know, time to be like, leave the world behind and get your sleep on too if you need it. This is a great time to get your sleep on. I stayed in bed a little extra yesterday and today and probably maybe tomorrow, and I just cuddled because I was like, ugh. I usually jump out of bed. I'm one of those people that hops out of bed real quick because I got stuff to do and I'm excited to do it. But during new moon in Cancer, give yourself the extra, give yourself the extra time in the shower. Give yourself that extra time in the bath to be like, because we need it. We need to nurture ourselves. Boundaries is that cafecito break. Yes, yes, yes. Hola, Sunflower. ¿Cómo estás, mi amor? Hello, welcome. Iris says, parentified child, inner child healing and reparenting the self is super necessary. The article has great insight on that. Thank you, Iris, thank you. It is so important. And with the new moon in Cancer, I mean, next time the new moon comes up, maybe I'll do an article on inner child healing, right? Leo is the inner child, but yet Cancer, what is our relationship with our mother? The relationship with our mother affects everything in our lives. It affects how we even view other women. It affects how we view authority figures that are female. It even affects how we deal with our own womanhood, right? Our own motherhood, our own wanting to have children or not, etc. And so there's so much juicy stuff to do there. Let's see. Cindy, hola, hello. Anyone else have any questions? If you're just joining the room, we're talking about new moon in Cancer, which is happening tonight at 9:36 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Oh, hello, Ziggy Mac, Ziggy Gogo, MZX. Welcome, Seaford. Yeah, pa fuera. It's true. And I want to bring something up, that cafecito break, because you said pa fuera like that. It just really brought this up. You know, as brujitas, as spiritual women, if you don't want to use that word, or as spiritual beings, we could say that, as spiritual beings, we're seeing so many articles in spirituality, we're seeing so many things and so many amazing products, right? Remember, our ancestors used what they had. Y lo más importante, the most important thing is our intention. And so sometimes my students reach out, they're like, Vanessa, I was so tired today. I was a mom, I had to work, I had to do this. I didn't get to do the ritual. And I'm like, you were the living ritual. And so receive that too. Doing rituals is beautiful and amazing because it lets us take that self-care time. But we are love in motion. We are pouring love into our work, into our everyday. We are a living ritual. Our breathing in and breathing out and being here connected with each other are showing up in the world to make ripple effects. And so if you don't get to do a ritual, if you don't get to light the candle, if you don't get to take the sacred bath, it's okay. Just breathe that moment and be like, yeah, this is new moon in Cancer, me changing some diapers. Or this is new moon in Cancer, me going to work, because it's part of everyday life. Now, I wanted to say, if you don't get to do something tonight at 9:36 p.m., it's okay, because you still got tomorrow and the day after. There's still more time. Does anybody else have any other questions about the new moon in Cancer? Do we have any Cancers in the house? I would love to hear, hola, Cindy love, baby babe, ¿cómo están? If you're enjoying this conversation, please share it. Tag some friends, bring them in. Cafecito break es verdad. Work with what you have. That's part of the medicine, absolutely. And unfortunately, you know, there's some propaganda and other stuff telling us that we absolutely need all these things, right? Oh, Glow and Greens posted something. But what we really need is ourselves. And guess what? We have it. Because at the end of the day, we truly do have everything that we need within us. Is that, of course, we're going to want to learn stuff. We're going to want to learn, develop abilities. But oh, we have our soul. We have our breath. We have our hearts. We have our bodies. We have our spirit. And then everything else. And so remember that your intention is really powerful. Something that I love to do, and I used to do it more when I was younger, but I still do it now, is writing that one powerful statement that you vibrate to, put it up on the wall. So years ago, before I started working on my own and having my own business, I was working at a university and I was at my desk and I wrote, "The universe is conspiring towards my outrageous success." And I printed it out and I put it there. And you know, there were a couple of snickers. There were a couple of people like, what outrageous success is this girl talking about? And you know, when I look back, that's about 12, 13 years ago. And I mean, building your own business and doing your own thing and getting paid and being able to make an impact, right? And I look back and I'm like, wow. And so whatever it is for you, is it the self-care? Is it the universe is conspiring towards my outrageous healing? Is it the universe is conspiring towards my outrageous joy? Is it that the universe is conspiring to outrageous opportunities and aligned clients and aligned jobs and aligned or a love partner? Or if you're looking to adopt that beautiful child that you're meant to align with, allow yourself to write that out, post it somewhere around you, on your computer, on the wall, wherever it may be, because words are powerful and words are spells. Words are spells. And a lot of times we're like, pero no tengo esto, I don't have this, I don't have the time. Remember that words are spells. And we're all brujitas in our own way. Glow and Greens, what does the new moon in Cancer mean for a Taurus? Thank you so much for all the knowledge you're sharing. It's been received with an open heart. Gracias, Glow and Greens. I'm a Taurus too. Taurus is in the house. So I wanna say this, okay? I know that some people, the minute they see like the moon in Cancer, they start crying. And they're like, oh, I'm laying around, I can't move, right? If that happens naturally, it's okay. But let's not also like kind of psych ourselves out, right? We're gonna be more emotional. Like I said, I cried today at the gym because I thought about my parents and I thought about my brother. And I'm like, yeah, I'd like them to be at my wedding. And I know they'll be there in spirit. So I got emotional, I cried, I blew my nose, right? And then I continued my workout thinking of them and that they'd be proud. So with Taurus is an earth sign. Taurus is an earth sign. I actually took some notes here. So I want to look quickly to see if I have them. But Taurus is an earth sign. And what happens is earth and water, of course, we can say that they make mud, but let's not say that. What they make is fertile ground. And so for Taurus, the moon in Cancer is awesome. What I'm getting strongly for you, though, as a Taurus, is to release some of these stories about your lovability, because Taurus is really about self-worth and is really about having all of this like embodied lusciousness, security already. But sometimes the Taurus looks outside. And so just know, Glow and Greens, like I love that name and it's so appropriate for you. If that's the work that you're doing, you're totally on point because the Taurus helping people thrive and be more healthy. But for you, it's gonna be good. It's going to support you in releasing the past like others, but for you, search deeply to find if there's a particular memory or thing where you receive the message that maybe you weren't worthy or you weren't like worthiness is coming up, like you weren't worthy or lovability, and just keep working on and connecting to the energy of I am lovable, I am deserving. And in that deserving and in that being lovable, you're gonna attract everything that you need. So it's really great for Taurus. And I just wanna say this because I took some notes. Communication is gonna be the focus for you, right? Also, and then what I was saying, the words that we say to ourselves, I am lovable, no matter what my relationship with anybody was. It is about taking back your power through your voice. The Taurus also rules the throat. So Taurus rules the throat. We get colds. I get laryngitis sometimes also because I talk a lot. But it's about healing the throat by speaking our truth. And I want to say something. Taurus likes to keep the peace, okay? Taurus likes to keep the peace. I mean, it takes a lot for us to be the bull in the china shop and then we're like, we're not going to take it anymore. But in general, Taurus likes to keep the peace. During this new moon in Cancer, you're invited to speak more of your truth. Start with yourself. Start with yourself. Speak the truth to yourself first. Because I find sometimes that a lot of us, we walk around and we're like, I told them, and I told her, and I told them. But it's like, wait a minute, still going out? How about, what are the words that you're saying to yourself? And what truth do we need to embrace and what you need to embrace? So I hope that helps, glowing greens. Yay. Wow, we've been going strong for like 30 minutes. I love it. Hola, Eligari, ¿cómo estás? Iris, oh, bird, gotta take flight and leave the nest and family birdcage. Feel that, yes, 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 yes. And I'll tell you, like, by the time my parents passed, they were very approving of my career, but there's mediums and psychics and brujas and healers in my family from lineage, but they didn't tell anybody. So what I'm doing is like breaking that chain, and they were scared for me. But after years of them seeing that I was safe, I was okay, I was succeeding, I was taking care of myself, you know, but I had to show them and I had to kind of like not talk about it, be like, no quiero oír, estoy bien, I'm okay. So it was a little bit of a battle, and sometimes that happens. Remember that our parents grew up at a different time, right? Our parents grew up at a different time, and if it feels like they're trying to hold us back, so it's not really that. It is really that they're trying to do the best they can. They're still trying to take care of us. So be mindful too that if you have a Cancer mom, they may be overprotective. If there's a new moon now and you're a Cancer, you may be overprotective. The energy in the smother mother, and that all that comes into play as well. Yes, gracias, Reina. Thank you, Cafecito Break. Thank you, mi amor. Yeah, I'm excited. Jenny, welcome. Gabby, Arcy. Congratulations. Yes, I'm so excited. Hello, I'm Victoria Jen. Powerful lady there. Short but funky. I love that name. I'm short too. Yes, fell asleep at 6:30 p.m. yesterday, exhausted. Yes, we're going to be tired with this new moon because we're in the process of releasing. And also, Mercury that was retrograde, going backwards, is now direct. And so we're going to speed up on technology, things, opportunities, movement. And we have to ask ourselves, well, is this really good for me? My ego wants it, right? My ego wants it, but is it good for me? Thank you for that. Permission noted. Yes, Iris. Amanda, great to have you here, mi amor. JBABY3, hello. Seafern, sending you so much love. Okay, I love this question. I think we're gonna go like 10 more minutes, and then we're gonna like come out of this. But I love this. You know, I could talk forever. So XGG Mac Geo Mac MZG X says, "What if someone doesn't have the greatest relationship with their mother?" Well, I think even the folks who have a great relationship, there's still another side. Because remember, right? So I want to explain one thing. So the sun sign. Represents our character, our identity. It represents who we are and who we're evolving into in this life. The moon represents our emotional processes, our mother, and our feelings. And so very much our identity and our emotions need to work together. When we have a new moon in Cancer, it's gonna ask us, how are we processing our feelings? And a lot of times it's gonna ask us, how are we processing our feelings with our mother? And so what I would invite you to do, XGG, OMZX, is to read the article. And laughter yoga helps with inner child healing, absolutely. And I would say during this time, maybe build a little altar if you haven't yet. What I would do, and an altar doesn't have to be complicated. It could be like three cositas on your desk, like three little things. You know, when I used to work in corporate, no one knew I had a little altar on my desk. They just did not know. They did not know because it was just right there in front of them. There were flowers, there was a crystal, and there was a vision board that was like this big. And so set up a little space in your home. And this could be for anybody, right, who's dealing with mother stuff. Read the article because that'll help you with questions. But also, create a little space and find a picture of yourself. And if you don't have a picture of your baby self or your little self, you can, you know, cut out a picture of a baby that you feel connected to. And maybe put something that reminds you of childhood. Is it a little toy? Is it a balloon? Is it something, whatever it is? It could be something at home. Do you have a little toy from childhood? Put it there. And then I would write down, I am in the process of healing my relationship with my mother, right? I'm in the process of healing my relationship with my mother. And then take a moment, light a candle, allow yourself to close your eyes, right? And just breathe really deeply. And it's about dropping into your body, dropping into your energy, allowing yourself to be embodied. And when you drop in, imagine that inner child. And do that visualization where you ask your inner nene or inner nena, hey, what do you wish that you would have received from your mom? And that's, you know, reparenting. Asking our inner selves, our inner child, what do we wish that we had received, right? What do we wish that we had received? And then giving it to ourselves. And so when you ask your inner child, allow the tears to flow if you have it, right? And if you're not ready to forgive your mom, because a lot of people write me, they're like, how can I heal my relationship with my mom and have us be best friends? And I'm like, well, the first thing is to face the fact that you may never be best friends. The thing is, you can be your own best friend. You could have your own back. But sometimes we have to understand that our mothers are not ready. They may have mental health issues. They may have a different, you know, way of being, of being raised, a different perspective on life. I mean, mothers that are you know, from the old country, from our South America or island or wherever we come from, and then las madres que están aquí, the mothers who were born here, there's different. I came here as a baby, right? But I'm very American, though Latin American too. So my mom and I clashed, even though we were good together in many ways. And so taking the time to meditate, ask your inner self, your inner child, what did I need? And your inner child might say, I need more laughter and play. Mommy didn't play with me enough. Mom doesn't listen to me. Mom doesn't believe in me. And then ask yourself in turn, how can I believe in myself? Is there something that I've been holding back on because I don't believe in myself? Now's the time to take the chance, right? Is there something I've been putting up with, abuse from a friend or someone, because your inner child says, well, mom trampled over my boundaries. Okay, how am I allowing other people to trample over my boundaries? And so having this inner dialogue with our inner child then gives us tools to be able to come out and answer those questions for ourselves and be in process. Healing happens in a process. Right? They say, magically speaking, shamanically speaking, que parecen una espiral. It's a spiral. So we have issues with our mom, and then we go to therapy, and then we're like, oh, I feel better, but it's not completely healed. Because then you go to family gatherings, and you're like, ah, this woman, right? Esta señora. And then the spiral goes around again, and you're like, boom. And so this is what happens. So be patient with yourself. Allow yourself time to play with your inner child. And I'll tell you, like my inner child, my mom was pretty good to a certain point, but then she had three other children and a child with a heart condition. So she always said to me, well, you're fine. You'll take care of yourself. What wound up happening is I became like an overachieving, take care of everybody person. What I need to reparent myself, and using myself as an example, I need play. And so I joined improv when I moved to Pennsylvania, and I allowed myself to do an activity with no desire to achieve anything. Meaning I wasn't gonna be the best, I'm not gonna go be an actress, I'm not gonna go and try to audition for Broadway, I'm just gonna allow myself to play. And so check in with yourself where you didn't get something in childhood and what do you need, because I know I need to be silly. And that's something that I understood when I chose my partner. If I can be silly in front of him and allow myself to play, then I'm in a right relationship. Because most of the time I'm pretty serious, right? I'm a hypnotherapist, I'm an astrologer, I write, I support people in a lot of healing sessions. I've got to be serious. People are telling me deep things. At the same time, laughter and joy for all of us help us, but for me in particularly because I've been serious at a young age. So XGGGGOMXMZX, let me know if that served you. Let me know if that helped you. Let me look real quick at Leo's, and then we're going to start wrapping it up a little bit because I took notes here and I just want to remind myself. With Leo's and... Okay, let me, because I took these notes. Okay, Leos. For Leos, the new moon in Cancer is good. You might find, again, yourself, like all of us, crying a little bit, you know, in the corners for something. And for you, there's a deep invitation because we're headed to Leo season. And by the way, Venus is in Leo. So if you're a Leo and you're here, Venus is in Leo and Mars in Leo. You might want to be a little more like sensual right now. You might want to express your feelings. Doesn't necessarily mean you have to have sex or anything like that, but you may want to hug people more, kiss people more, or be more affectionate because we've got the planet of values and love in your sign. We also have Mars. You might feel a little more energy like that. Starting a workout would be a workout regimen would be really awesome for Leos. Also know that if you've been burning the candle at both ends, Leo, new moon in Cancer is like, take a break before I make you take a break. In a kind way, but still. And so I hope that helped you, Leo. That's what it's about for you. She has no rules. I love that name. Oh my God. Vanessa Jimenez, hola. Sunny rays, Cancer rising. Let me talk about Cancer rising. I'm still trying to get off in like 3 minutes, but sunny rays, Cancer rising. So what's gonna be extra illuminated for you? Okay, if you are Cancer rising, if you have a moon in Cancer, you might be a little extra nostalgic. You may be a little extra intuitive and psychic. You may be a little more extra aware and sensitive of what's happening with you and what's happening to other people. So I would suggest that you read the article and take that time to get away from everyone, because it's like Cancer has the antenna. I mean, we all have antenna, but Cancer on your moon, the new moon in Cancer, you got super duper crazy antennas like da 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 da. And you may not know what the antenna is picking up. And what I mean by the antenna is intuition, right? The antenna that picks up information. And so you're sitting there doing your laundry and suddenly you're like, oh, I feel anxious. I don't know why. And maybe your child is having issues at school. You're doing there typing away at work, doing your thing. And suddenly you're like, I don't know. I feel so sad, or I feel so happy. Cancer is very intuitive. You're more psychic than you think you are. You're going to be more sensitive during this new moon. So a great idea for you guys is, after you do the questions that are in the article in New Moon and Cancer, what I would do if I were you is I would also sit down, take 3 deep breaths, go in, call my intuition, just be like, hey, intuition, I want to talk to you, right? Because we're building a dialogue. And then asking, what do I need to know for this new moon? And that's a great exercise for everybody. But new moon, for Cancer rising and Cancer moon, you're picking up things and you may not know what you're picking up. So it's up to you to get clarity. And what happens is a lot of Cancer risings and Cancer moons, you're empaths. What does that mean? You pick up intuitive information through your emotions, but the intuitive information doesn't usually come with a explanation or a manual. So you're like, it's coming at you and you don't know what's happening. So get away from everybody if you can, even if it's locking yourself in a bathroom. Take a baño, take a cleanse, even if it's just a regular shower. Be like, I release and I gain clarity. And then ask yourself that question, what do I most need to know during this new moon in Cancer? I can't go through all the signs, but what I would say, because we've been here for almost 45 minutes, but it's a great question. It's gonna affect everybody differently. Some people might go more to intuitive. Some people may go more to nostalgic. Everybody's gonna get it differently. This I will say, if you are an earth sign, it's gonna make you feel way more like, kind of like a little vague with yourself, so take time away. If you are a water sign, you're definitely gonna be more sensitive. I don't care if you're a Pisces, a Scorpio, or a Cancer, you're gonna be more sensitive. If you're an air sign, you're gonna be like, and if you're single and an air sign, you may suddenly be like, okay, what's up in my love life, right? It could be affecting the love life. Like, what's going on? I'm working a lot. I'm thinking a lot. I have friends. I have conversations. Things are good. Or I'm married and I'm an air sign and I'm like, when's the last time I had a date with my partner? So it's going to invite you into love and explore those things. And if you're a fire sign, Cancer is a cardinal sign. Cardinal means initiator. So it's not like a fixed sign like Scorpio. Scorpio is a little more stuck in their ways. Cancer is more like, all right, what do we need to do? Let's do it. So for fire, check yourself, because you might get a little too emotional and want to like speak up real fast, and the wrong person might get the communication. And this is very general, right? This is a very general thing. Everybody's different. We have different natal charts, but it's important. Yes, Cancer, Sun, Jess, you're going to be more sensitive and you're going to be connecting to that energy. XGG, oh, definitely enjoying it. I'm so glad. Yulis, yes. Cafecito break. My sis and I have a botanica in Brooklyn. We share this message of working with what you have often. Get to simple. Thank you, Cafecito break. I want to connect with you and maybe bring you onto my podcast. I'd love to connect with you. Thank you for being here. Yes, get to the simple. It doesn't need to be complicated, but yet, you know, because spirituality has been commodified, right? Let me get back. I just kind of lost us. Because spirituality has been commodified, I mean, sadly, what's happened, as we all know, is that a lot of our spiritual practices were taken from our ancestors. They were taken from the indigenous communities and Afro communities and even European communities, and then repackaged and sold to us. And we're in a very powerful time of reclamation where we're seeing more healers, more astrologers, and we're like, okay, you know, I want to work on myself. I want to heal myself. How do I do this? And beginning with what is, beginning with our breath, we have what it takes right here, okay? And that's what you need to know. And thank you, Cafecito Break, sending you so much love. Yoli75, feeling all the feels, but also a sense of peace and calm. That was much needed after that retrograde. Hello, Sunny Rays. Woo, eclipses and retrogrades. We need it. Vanessa Jimenez, thank you. Thank you for loving it. Post, go to Be Latina News, read the article. In 2 weeks, I come out again. After I'm married, I'm coming up with a couple of other ideas to share on Be Latina News with articles to educate us more in astrology. So yes, gracias Vanessa Jimenez, Norma Quintana, hola querida, hola Norma, so great to have you here. Yes, this Cancer season has been so emotional. I haven't cried this much in so long. And you know what? Let us be okay with tears. I could tell you when I was younger, I was scared. I didn't want to cry. I wanted to be a strong girl for everybody. I cry every day, people. I cry every day. Sending you love. I cry every day. And it could be like tears of joy. It could be tears of sadness for the world and anger. And I think that keeps me healthy. Honestly, I think it keeps me healthy because it's like, and I let it go. And then I'm making a joke and having a good time. Now, everybody's built differently. Some people hold on to things more, depending on their natal chart. But if you're crying, cry. Suéltalo, suéltalo, suéltalo. As Cafecito Break said, pa' fuera. The good, yes, Chin Chin Cat, fabulous 19. Thank you all for being here. It's been so good. Glow Green says, thank you. You're welcome. You're welcome. Sending you all so much love. Thank you for all your wisdom, Vanessa, Ashanti Universe. You're so welcome. I hope to be back. Cabecito Break, que bueno. Tired is an understatement. Ah, no. Sunflower, thank you for the conversation. You're so welcome. And thank you, Be Latina News, for having me and for having us. I don't think that we were all thinking it was going to be this long, but hey, going with the flow. Olives and Linen, hola, Angela, Joanne. Please follow Be Latina News. Check out their articles. They're such amazing articles every day, keeping you up to date with what's happening, not only in the astrological world, in the everyday world of news, with incredibly powerful articles on powerful Latinas, powerful Latinos, and what's happening in the world. And so thank you all. Mystical Mandela's here. Can you talk a little about Scorpio during the season? I did just now. I said, you know, very emotional, but not willing to change sometimes because it's a fixed sign. So be mindful and just go to the article and do the questions, because the article itself is like a mini workshop to guide you through this moon. Yes, Cancer moon and Cancer rising here, and I definitely am feeling everyone else's vibes. Yes, let's do it. So good, mi amor. Good. Let's reach out. Vanessa Jimenez, sending you stars. Mariela Music. Yes, yes, yes. I'm just Allie. Bueno, everybody, thank you so much for being here. This is the first astrology, you know, Q&A that we've had. I've been honored to be here with Be Latina News. Gracias, gracias, gracias. Thank you for each and every one of you to be here. And remember, the new moon's about taking really good care of ourselves. And it's more than skin deep. Go to the deeper stuff. You'll be so grateful. Because we got Leo moon coming up. The new moon's going to be, Leo season coming up. And Leo season's going to be like coming out, sharing, being creative. And that can really fully happen once we've done the inner work. So, mucho amor. Nos vemos. Bye, everyone. Thank you.